Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today I am on my Axum DP. I am on a rather green trail with some light blue sections in it. And I decided just to make a short video, me just kind of using the bike, because a lot of these, the bigger channels, they'll use these cheaper bikes for content, do some upgrades, then move on. But in my case, this is actually my bike. I have a full suspension bike. I have a hardtail. The Axum DP is my hardtail. Now it's heavily upgraded, and I'll put the upgrades down in the description. But I'm really satisfied with all the upgrades I've done. And definitely the bike's a keeper. I don't know if it's even fair to call it an Axum DP anymore, because the only thing that's left is the frame and the dropper post. Everything else has been changed and upgraded. But the bike works great, and hopefully I will keep riding it. I'll ride in some more advanced trails, and hopefully I can do a long-term follow-up on the bike and how it rides and how it holds up. One of the previous upgrades, for example, was the Bucklows fork, and I was hoping it really worked, but for the type of riding I wanna do on this bike, and since I do wanna keep it long-term, I went ahead and changed the fork to a much nicer RockShox Recon. Even though I still stand by the fact that that Bucklows, if you're gonna stick to green trails or pathways or greenways, then that's a really good fork. Being on some of the Axum groups, I realized that not everybody really rides their Axum out in trails or in difficult trails. They do mild trails, they do greenways, they do all kinds of riding. So that Bucklows is really a good upgrade from suspension fork that comes with this bike. Now, if you're gonna stick to greenways, I would honestly just probably keep the original fork on it, unless you really want to shave off some weight. You can shave off probably about 2 pounds of weight just from changing the fork on this bike, but for a little extra money you can get the RockShox, which is much nicer than the Bucklows, and it is nicer than the Suntour XCR Air also. So I hope you keep watching some of my videos, look back and see how the upgrades on this bike went step by step, and check out some of my other maintenance videos and such. So I'm reaching about 5,000 subscribers, and I'm hoping to start making a little better quality videos than what I've done in the past. So hopefully that's going to happen. And again, thanks for watching. Subscribe, give it a thumbs up. See you next time.